Welcome to my kitchen. You might be asking, why are you wearing a face mask in your own house? Well, it's because you guys are in for a treat. These delicious cookies are found in the Contempo Cafe in the Contemporary Resort at Walt Disney World. And a friend of mine grabbed me this one, and she also grabbed me a couple of things, so stay tuned for those. And I can't wait any longer to try this out. I think we should try this at a very magical place. What do you think?
Yes, but where?
Buena Vista Street just opened up again. We do have a vlog on that one, so I'll make sure I link it. But I think we could find a very festive place to try in DCA. And you guys are in for a treat because I will be recreating this cookie. So I'm really excited to make this for you guys and send some out to you guys. So what do you think? Should we just go over to DCA now and try it out and then bake some cookies?
Yep, that sounds like a plan.
Since I do have my official cookie taster mask from Miss Purple Pie 13, you guys can see that video I did an unboxing when she sent me this mask and another one. I did get a gingerbread man! So right now at Disneyland, we don't have the gingerbread Mickeys just because, you know, the parks are so closed. But we do have the gingerbread Mickey cookies. And you guys can see that video. I will link that one as well too. But this one again is from the Contemporary Resort over in Walt Disney World. Let's try it out. And speaking of gingerbread, we have a special surprise, huh?
Mm-hmm.
That's soon to come. We've just been a little backed up with a lot of stuff that we're doing.
Yep.
But look, there he is. With a little hey Mickey. You came to visit one of my sisters. Alright guys, let's try it. Look at little hidden Mickey! Oh, I'm so sad to bite his head off.
His little head.
It's Disney. I don't know why, but their gingerbread cookies taste a lot different than the ones here.
The little gingerbread
guy. Isn't it cute?
Did you bite his head off?
Yes.
Where did you get the cookies?
At the Contemporary Resort in Walt Disney World. But they do have the Mickey gingerbread cookies here. So good. So good. I don't know why, but the gingerbread tastes different from the one here and over there.
Hmm.
Oh. But it's Disney magic.
Yep. Look like he had the satisfaction of biting his head off.
Yes. Don't look at the bite.
Yes, I would. Hey. I'll take a look at the little bite.
All right, are you ready to try this?
Yes, we are.
I'm so excited. All right, there it is. Ooh, I'm going to take a bite. Mmm. I feel like there's chocolate chip inside.
There? Are?
Mm-hmm. All right. You guys gotta stay tuned and see how I made mine and what items I added to them to make them special. It was really good.
They look really good. They can smell it from here.
Oh, it's really good. Mhm. So good. The Contempo Cafe. I'm excited. Alright. I have tons of chocolate in my mouth. But let's go back to the kitchen.
Alrighty.
Alright guys, so I picked this up Trader Joe's. It's a chocolate peppermint loaf and cooking mix. Here are the instructions. I'll make sure I write everything down below for you guys and all the directions. I have some leftover chocolate we need to melt so we can drizzle on top and some crushed peppermint. I picked this up from Michael's. It makes everything a lot easier once it's already crushed, but you could crush it yourself if you want. And we got 2 eggs. Some vegetable oil. We're gonna need 1/3 cup to be precise. I also have this cute spatula. My cookie sheet ready with some parchment paper. And last but not least, we're gonna need a mixing bowl. You guys ready? Okay, so this is what the mix looks like. You have to add the whole mix into the bowl. So let's get started. Okay, so you first have to preheat your oven to 350. Now you have to combine the eggs and the oil first. And I didn't even notice until now, but I spot a hidden Mickey. Do you guys see that? All right, add your 2 eggs and then add your shortening. Okay, now it's time to mix the eggs and the shortening. And once it's mixed well, we're gonna be adding the cooking mix.
All right, perfect. Now I'm going to be adding the mix, and I'm going to be using the spatula to mix everything together.
Christmas Eve. Jingle jangle. Jingle jangle. Jingle jangle.
Okay, we're not quite done yet mixing everything, but I do want to add a little touch, and I'm going to be adding some crushed peppermint inside to make it a little more minty than what the contemporary ones will have. The dough is to the point where it's getting a little hard to be mixed with the spatula. I'm a very hands-on person, so I'm going to be using my hands to form the dough. Once the dough has the consistency you want, you have to form 1-inch balls and put them in your cookie sheet. All right, so one down. Let's see how many we can make from this batch. I'm trying to make them about the same size as the contemporary ones, so we'll see how many come out. Alright guys, so I got about 12 cookies on the sheet. Let's see how many more I can get out of the leftover dough. Time to put them inside the oven. So remember, the oven is at 350 degrees. They have to be in there for 12 minutes, and then we have to let them cool down for 2 minutes. Now it's time to melt some chocolate. Okay guys, so around 10 minutes or so, I took out the cookies and I pressed them down because they were a little fluffier than I wanted them. But they are now ready to be cooled down, so I have another cookie sheet. And I put parchment paper to cool them down, where you just have to let them cool down for 2 minutes, and then we could drizzle on some chocolate. Alright guys, now it's time to drizzle them with some chocolate. We're almost done, guys. Time to add the peppermint. Okay guys, we just need to let them cool down and then they'll be ready to be packaged. I am so excited, can't wait to hear your thoughts. And this was actually pretty fun. It was pretty simple using the mix, but I will definitely try making my own soon. And here they are guys! They are cooled down and packaged, and I can't wait for you guys to try them. Let me know in the comments down below if you like this video, and also if you guys receive one, let me know. I always like hearing your honest opinions. and can't wait to make another video soon. Enjoy, guys.